Okay, folks, I'm down at the hole here. The old honey hole. And, I'm gonna get started in there. Found some nice finds here lately, so I'm back in there quite a ways. And you can see I'm gonna have to bring these trees down here at some point. They're kind of sloped this way because I've dug out all in there and it's kind of fell back this way. So at some point I'm gonna have to get them out of there. Clean this all out so I can go in further, closer to the bank there, and travel up. All right, so let's get started. Got a bottle in the hole, folks. It's way in there. Right there. So I'm gonna go in. See about scraping it out. Once you get in there like that, you gotta be real careful with your shovel. You gotta keep an eye out for any bit of glass because you could hit it with your shovel and break it real easy. So I'm just gonna try scraping it out real easy with this. From here it looks like manganese glass, but it could just be discolored. Okay, it looks like a slicker. Let's get it out. Yeah, it's just a slicker. It's blown. And I'm trying to see if it's got a tooled lip. It does have a tooled lip. But it's an early one. That might be manganese glass. That's a big bubble, isn't it? Okay, let's keep going. I'm gonna put the camera on for a bit there, folks, while I scrape away in here. I don't like getting in here too far since I'm digging by myself. Digging alone, but I was digging way down in that corner. You can't really see it, but I was getting in there a little too far, I think, for my own safety, so I'm going to start scraping away up in here and try to get this big piece of metal out of there. Let's see what falls out of the wall here. Nice piece of crockery. There's some more to it. Okay, there's a neat bottle. There's a cork top too. Oh, probably an olive oil bottle or something. Looks like it's from the late 20s or 30s most likely. Yeah, I'd say. Oh boys, I don't know if that's machine made or not. That almost looks blown. I wouldn't bet on it though, but all right. That's I'm gonna dump that out and I'll get you back up in a bit maybe.
I'd like me a splash of whiskey to wash the trail dust off in me gullet and keep my singing voice in fettle.
Whiskey's illegal. This is a tri-county.
Well, what are they drinking?
Whiskey. These outlaws.
Oh, well, don't let my white duds and pleasant demeanor fool you. I, too, have been known to violate the statutes of man, and not a few of the laws of the Almighty.
You ain't no outlaw. And we don't drink with tin horns.
Just pulled this one out of the sidewall, folks. It's just a slick amber chemical bottle of some sort. Nice big round one. Right. And this olive bottle or whatever it is most definitely blown with a tooled lip. And the reason I was questioning it is because it's got the Dominion glass mark on the base. And that would put it after 1928 or 1928 and after, which is kind of late for blown bottles, but there you go. I found another Dominion glass bottle last year, I think, that was also blown. So that's interesting. Well, let's keep going. Still plugging away here, folks. I think I got a cool perfume here. Let's go in the hole, check it out. Right here. Still got the stopper in it, check that out. Doesn't appear to be embossed, but that's pretty cool with the stopper. Yeah. Got some liquid in it too. Nice little find. Can't tell if it's blown or not. I'm gonna have to say, yeah, it looks like it is blown. Tooled lip. That'll look good cleaned up, yep. Yep, well. Nice. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Good little find right there.
Sir, it seems that you are no better a judge of human beings than you are a specimen of one. Just on a brief inventory, I'd say that you could use yourself a shave and a brighter disposition. And lastly, if you don't mind me aspersing your friends, a better class of drinking buddy.
You're shooting ironwork.
Big ol' link there, folks. I almost huffed that one down over the bank. Big ol' cork top. Barrel shaped. I don't see any embossing on it. Well, lots of times it's hard to tell, though, all that dirt on it, but I can't even tell if it's blown or if it's machine made. It's all caving in there. Well, we'll take it and get it cleaned up. It's a pretty good size one. I just had a bit of a cave in here, folks. This fell out. Looks to be whole. Nice Kepler. Yep. Cool. This here just fell out right on top of the pile. Just a slick medicine. This one here looks like a poison iodine. Looks like a poison iodine. It is. It is. Right there, check it out. There it is. Right on, right on, right on. Oh man, I'm surprised I don't find more of these down here. Cool beans. Awesome. Well, I wasn't expecting to find that today. Yep. Folks, I got ginger beer in here. Right here. I know you can't see it very well with the lighting, but I'm going to try to scrape it out. Hope that it's whole, and hopefully this doesn't collapse in on us in the meantime. It looks like it's good from here. Let's try that. Yep. It's a good one. Check it out. Old Homestead ginger beer. Okay, I'm going to shut you off and get you back out there in the light. Okay, there it is, folks. It's got two chips up around the lip, you can see. That one there and that one there. But other than that, it looks to be in mint condition. As long as I can get that rust off it. Quite heavy, too. Yeah, the base doesn't look to be chipped up at all. All right, I'm happy with that find. I think I'm going to get out here now. I got a few things here, maybe enough to put a video together. A couple decent ones. Okay, let's get out of here, folks. We'll see you on the cleanup.
Appears to do, yes. Huh. It appears that the vitals of this lucky son of a gun remain unpunctured. Sloppy shooting on my part. Here now. I'll get that for you, partner. The coup de grace I'll leave to the wolves and Gila monsters. Adios, amigo.